According to Walmart, 90% of Americans live within 10 miles of one of its stores, but not the residents of Winnsboro, South Carolina. As NewsHour Weekend's Christopher Booker reported in 2016, Walmart closed its supercenter there 3 years ago, one of 154 it shuttered across the country that year, many of them in rural areas. He recently returned to Winnsboro to see what life after Walmart is like for a small American town.
When the news came in January of 2016 that Walmart would close the Winnsboro, South Carolina supercenter, residents were shocked.
We thought it was a prank at first. I said, Walmart closing? That's the only store we have around here.
I think that the customers deserve to know something. You know, I spent a lot of money at Walmart.
The closure was part of a restructuring effort that Walmart described in a press release as necessary to keep the company strong and positioned for the future. A Walmart spokesman told the NewsHour in 2016 that there was not a single factor, like profit or location, that determined which stores they closed and which remained open. And just 2 weeks after the announcement, Winnsboro's Walmart shut its doors. For nearly 20 years, the store had served as the town's one-stop shop, the place where residents could buy groceries, fill their prescriptions, or just catch up with their neighbors.
Or if you wanted to see anybody, come to Walmart. This is where everybody would be.
But convenience had come at a cost for Winnsboro. Competing with Walmart's rock-bottom prices was difficult for the town's existing businesses. When Walmart arrived in 1998, the town had three grocery stores and two department stores. By the time it left Winnsboro, only the Buy Low grocery remained. But it was downtown, about 2 miles away from Walmart, that took the biggest hit.
I came to Winnsboro a year and a half before Walmart.
Terry Vickers was president of the Chamber of Commerce when Walmart opened in 1998.
There were some smaller shops, sandwich shop, bookstore, small mom and pops on the street. And while some of those small shops were able to stay open, a few of them, you know, just had to close their doors.
There may be some benefits of not having a Walmart here, but there'll be a gradual curve where the niches are replaced by other business entities.
How you doing, buddy?
Doing fine.
In 2016, Dr. Roger Gaddy, a local physician and also the town's mayor, saw Walmart's departure as an opportunity for the town.
When Walmart comes, the small mom and pops close. So we're hoping that whenever Walmart leaves, some of the small mom and pop stores and specialty stores will reopen and has the potential to help revitalize Main Street.
If we come back, what do you think we'll see in Winnsboro?
I would like to think that you would see a revitalization of downtown. You'll see more small specialty shops downtown. You'll see more people shopping downtown. I hope you'll see another grocery store. And so that's what I'm hoping that you'll see.
3 years later in 2019, we did come back to Winnsboro and found that at least one of the mayor's projections has come to pass. A second grocery store did open after the Walmart closed, right next to a new sporting goods store and a new discount store. And fortunes have improved for some of the small businesses that had managed to weather the Walmart years. The local hardware store says business has increased by 20% since the supercenter left. And the downtown pharmacy manager, Carrie Baker, says business has nearly doubled.
We just have more business, and our numbers have increased. We're now staying open on Wednesdays, when we used to close at 1 o'clock. Now we're here all day on Wednesdays.
And there are a few new faces.
Believe it or not, what convinced us to open was the fact there was nothing here.
Crystal Polk and her family moved from Connecticut to South Carolina a few years ago. Following the success of her family's food truck business in nearby Columbia, they decided to open a donut shop in Winnsboro in 2017.
I mean, people would say, Winnsboro, are you serious? Why? And I'm like, why not? It was just, Winnsboro's a place where there isn't anything here, you know? And I don't mean that in a negative, but it's a small place, so there's not a lot, you know? But what there is, it's what is here is unique.
Polk says business has been steady. Steady enough that they're making plans to open a restaurant next door.
We have relationship with people, you know. We see people who are once pregnant and now they have their, you know, they're coming in with a little girl, a little boy, you know. And that's just super cool.
But those are the exceptions. Much of downtown Winnsboro remains like it was when Walmart closed its doors in 2016.
The businesses down here, outside of a few, are still struggling.
Gene Stevens took over as president of the Chamber of Commerce when Terry Vickers retired last December. He says about a quarter of the downtown storefronts remain vacant.
Some people are hesitant to purchase these buildings, rent these buildings, and do that work because the investment is so large up front to get them back up.
It's been 3 years since Walmart closed. Do you think Walmart owes the town of Winnsboro anything?
Me personally, I don't think so.
Is there any validity to the argument that, well, the community supported Walmart?
I do believe if you ask the majority of the population, they would say that the Walmart did owe, the corporation did owe something because of the way they impacted the communities. You know, something that will help us revitalize to get back to where we were before Walmart came.
When Walmart left Winnsboro, it did contribute $30,000 to the county's Community Development Corporation. But even those who were optimistic concede hopes to restore downtown may have been premature.
We've got some people that want to, you know, want downtown to be reignited, rejuvenated, and, you know, that's just not happening anywhere to amount to anything. There'll have to be some major changes in the population and for that to occur.
Mayor Gaddy now believes the fate of downtown is tied not to what happens to the storefronts, but what happens just outside of town. In December, after sitting empty for nearly a decade, the town's former Mack truck production facility was sold to a Chinese mattress manufacturer. They're expected to open this year and hire 250 workers. But Gaddy's focus is on another project. Winnsboro sits between Columbia, South Carolina, and Charlotte, North Carolina. State and county officials are marketing the I-77 International Megasite, just 10 miles outside of Winnsboro on a 1,500-acre tract of land, as the location of the area's next major employer. The mayor is hoping it will lure an auto manufacturer that can bring 2,000 jobs or more. But if it comes, it won't come cheap.
Where the town really is involved with it is that we supply electricity and natural gas and water. I mean, we've floated about a $12 million bond to make sure we have a sustainable water supply for a reservoir to help with industrial recruitment.
$12 million is a big sum for a small town to gamble on recruiting a big company. But it's a gamble Mayor Gaddy believes they have to take.
To have downtown to be successful, you got to have a critical mass of people. To have the critical mass of people, you have to have the industry. To have the industry, you got to have the infrastructure. I'm kind of a basic thinker, and I said, we'll work on the infrastructure. Hopefully, industry will come. When the people get here, then downtown will have a much better opportunity to flourish. And, you know, it may or may not happen in my lifetime, but hopefully it won't be too long after that.
We at NewsHour Weekend would like to hear from viewers like you. What comments or questions do you have about this story? How has Walmart's presence or absence affected your community? Send us your thoughts at nhweekend@wnet.org. We may use your response in an upcoming program.